Hello and welcome to another episode of our Young Turk show, What's Trending. I am Arushi Ranjan and I am joined by my colleagues Ansh Pandey and Ishika Jaiswal. So, Lakshadweep versus Maldives, that's what's trending these days. I'll tell you briefly what exactly happened. PM Modi went to Lakshadweep to promote domestic tourism. But he urged Indian audience to visit places like Lakshadweep, Andaman Nicobar rather than going outside India. That's what exactly happened. Then some Maldivian ministers thought that it is an indirect way of calling out Maldives. And they took to social media, they came up, they said that they are hampering, Indian Prime Minister is hampering Maldives tourism. Then, of course, the Indian people, they had to reply back. They also came to social media with the hashtag boycott Maldives. And the people started saying that we should be visiting Lakshadweep or Andaman Nicobar or any other domestic place rather than going outside and Maldives, and specifically Maldives, because Maldives minister came out and said that it is an indirect way of saying all of that to Maldives. So that's what exactly happened briefly. Now, Ansh, I'll start with you. You must have seen PM Modi's dashing pictures circulating on social media he posted after his Lakshadweep visit. So, did you know that these beautiful pictures will turn out in something very controversial on social media?
Well, unexpectedly, no. I didn't imagine, but yes. Coming specifically to Maldives, Maldives ko laga, why did it happen exactly was ki President Muizu and his government is actually known for some anti-India stance, mostly in now times. Okay, he has just been elected, or election ke baad se hi uska ye stance raha hai ki quite not exactly like a hostile policy for India, but not quite supportive of India like the previous governments.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's the first thing. And second thing, coming to the point, is that no, I didn't expect it, and actually no one expected ki someone will take it too literally. And posting such derogatory comments about some Indians that they leave some smell behind. What kind of smell do we leave behind, ma'am? What kind of things are you saying? Yes. And actually after that, it started more like a social media war first, okay? And then, yeah, and then it became a whole diplomatic rift now. It is actually a whole diplomatic rift now. So yeah, that's what happened. But all in all, yeah, no one expected this to happen. कि एक छोटी सी पोस्ट से कोई इतना लिटरली किसी चीज को ले लेगा कि नहीं नहीं ये तो हम ही टारगेट
कर रहे हैं. And that was not even directly mentioning any country or any other person. It was saying that promote our domestic tourism.
Of course.
That's what PM Modi said. He didn't say don't go to Maldives or any other place. He just says promote domestic tourism rather than going outside. If you are getting the same thing in India, then why
there's one more thing. Prime Minister apne desh ka promotion karega to kiska karega bhai?
Of course
that's the first thing.
And the thing which you are saying about Mizu. So yes, he is taking anti India stance. India out, that's what they are doing.
India
I have
out.
Seen many pictures of Maldives people circulating online, even the president wearing a t-shirt of India out. So basically they are saying that Indian army or military should not be on Maldives border, they should be out from there. I think वो एक चीज होती है ना, अपने पैर पे खुद ही कुल्हाड़ी मारना.
Exactly, that's what they are doing.
Yeah,
that's what they are
doing. Take it in tourism or this Indian army thing, they are अपने पैर पे ही कुल्हाड़ी मार रहे हैं. So Ishika, before this controversy, did you ever think of going to Maldives, a tourist destination which everyone dream of going?
Coming from a middle class family, basically, I had never planned to go to Maldives because it's really expensive, to be very honest. And I think if you want white beach and, you know, beachy vibes, you can surely go to Lakshadweep because it's like really cheap. Tourism, I mean, the hotel cost and, you know, places are really very cheap than Maldives comparatively. And I think why not, you know, promote our domestic tourist destination rather than going outside.
So what's your plan now? Where are you visiting?
I am visiting Lakshadweep now next, if I get a chance.
Okay,
that's nice.
So we are talking about domestic tourism. So domestic tourism plays a bigger part when it comes to any country. It plays a role in growing economy. Yes, it does. It plays a role in growing culture, and of course, it plays a part in representing a nation in front of the world. So why not do that? What do you think? How can we promote the domestic tourism? If we talk about domestic tourism, then it's not only about islands like Lakshadweep and Andaman and Nicobar. Domestic tourism means promoting anything. India had so many historical places to visit. India had so many tourist places to visit. So what do you think? How can we promote that?
India, of course, India, मतलब एक चीज़ होती है कि even as a गली, कुछ गली की भी पुरानी पुरानी मान्यता होती है. जैसे for instance चांदनी चौक as a famous place known as पराठे वाली गली. Then we go to बनारस. बनारस has its own गलियों का flavor. So yeah, boosting domestic tourism is vital, first thing. And even I that firmly believe here कि हमारा खुद का जो domestic tourism है that is more important than the, I'm not saying that they don't have much good things out there, but we have a lot to explore about India, and that's why domestic tourism important hona chahiye. So haan, to domestic tourism ka I was quite zoned out about your question. Can I just get once more?
How can we promote domestic tourism of India, which PM Modi is asking about?
बहुत सारे तरीके हैं. पहली चीज तो it has to start with the पब्लिक अगेन. पब्लिक के दिमाग से पहले तो ये परसेप्शन हटानी पड़ेगी कि नॉट ओनली आउटसाइड, यू हैव योर ओन वर्ल्ड हियर. यू हैव अ सिविलाइजेशन दैट वाज 6000 और इवन मोर देन दैट इयर्स ओल्ड. ठीक है, यू हैव सो मेनी टेम्पल्स, यू हैव सो मेनी प्लेसेस, यू हैव सो मेनी फोर्ट्स दैट आर स्टिल अनडिस्कवर्ड. तो आप लोगों को पहले उनको देखिए. यू हैव सो मेनी कोरल रीव्स दैट आर स्टिल अनएक्सप्लोर्ड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लक्षद्वीप. लक्षद्वीप हैज अ वेरी बिग कोरल रीव जो अभी तक अनएक्सप्लोर्ड है. तो आप लोग उसे भी तो देखिए जाके.
What do you think, Ishika? How can the youth promote domestic tourism of India?
I think, for example, Goa, a very famous destination for youth. There are so many places in Goa which is really unexplored till now. So I think being Goa, I think Lakshadweep is also one where people should go. Or there are so many different places just still unexplored by the people. And I think a few days back I was seeing reels on Instagram. There were so many places near Mussoorie which is so beautiful, so like it doesn't really seem like it exists in India. Can you imagine? And people spend so much money and go out for the same view. And like, go explore. Exploring is the best part.
Exploring is the best policy.
And yeah, and you know, people.
So about the money thing, I think going internationally as a tourist and posting pictures on social media also presents a person's class. Now they're connecting it with that, because India mein to koi bhi ghoom lega. We will go internationally and show how rich we are to the social media people. So that is also, I think, it is being again connected to the class of a people and show off the social media world, basically. And on social media, hashtag boycott Maldives is trending. So what do you think about that? Is it right, or rather people should write hashtag support domestic tourism, because the celebrities who are taking stand, they are nowhere mentioning hashtag boycott Maldives. They are saying hashtag promote domestic tourism. So I'll ask you, will you go on social media and write something like hashtag boycott Maldives?
No, on personal front, no, I will not say that. But yes, there is one thing कि यू डोंट हैव दैट अथॉरिटी कि आप हमारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर के बारे में ऐसा बोलें. आउट ऑफ जस्ट एंगर, ओके, आउट ऑफ योर पर्सनल डिफरेंसेस, आपको कोई हक नहीं आप ऐसा बोलें. सेकेंड थिंग, नो, आई विल नेवर से कि नो बॉयकॉट मालदीव्स. मालदीव्स के पास भी बहुत कुछ है देखने को. दैट्स व्हाट आई विल से. बट यस, आपको अपने अंदर घूमना चाहिए. एंड कमिंग टू दिस पार्ट कि बॉयकॉट मालदीव्स वाला जो ये ट्रेंड स्टार्ट हुआ है, आई थिंक जो बॉयकॉट कर रहे हैं and those who are just saying ki domestic wale ko wo dekho zyada wo karo, I think both have the same goal ki rather than focusing outside, yeah, focus on inside first ki tumhare paas kya kya hai.
The thing here is that rather than seeing the negative part, we go for the positive one.
Feel
rather
positive
than saying
part,
that
yeah.
Don't go to a particular place, we will say go to our place. So the three leaders who has been suspended by Maldivian government for making derogatory comments on social media, I'll name out them. They are Malsha Sharif, Marian Shiona, and Abdullah Majum Majid. They have been suspended because they made some derogatory comments on social media about Indian Prime Minister and all of these controversy which is going on. What do you think, Ansh? Is it a way of Maldivian government to showing that we don't want to break the relations which we have with India, because India plays a major role in building their economy. So is it a wise move of Maldivian government to suspend these
definitely
leaders?
Definitely this is a wise move. Why we're trying to say this is basically trying to save the boat right now. Okay, definitely उन लोगों ने अपने personal Twitter handle से किया था, so this was not an official comment, but because they were the part of the government, everyone took it कि government का stance है. So पहली चीज़ हुई ये, and then after that the boycott Maldives trend started, and it became actually a trend. इतना बड़ा trend हो गया कि it has become a diplomatic group now. MEA their envoy came to the foreign affairs office today, by the way. Okay, and 5 minutes उनको वापस भेज दिया कि you go, we have just answered. Okay, so now they're trying to save the boat, because first thing is कि more or less आप चाहे कितना भी चाइना के साथ हाथ मिला ले, the fact remains is कि that अभी आपके बहुत सारे reliance इंडिया के ऊपर है, militarily, economically बहुत ज़्यादा. For now they are trying to throw the Indian, not throw, they are trying to make the presence of Indian military less in that area. But वो नहीं होगा इतनी जल्दी, इतना आसान नहीं होगा. India is somehow trying to stay there. And
it is
quite
Indian Ocean.
Yes, and it is quite necessary, because China जो है, China is making rounds all of a sudden in Indian Ocean. First thing. Second thing is कि coming to tourists, between 2019 to 2023 बहुत सारे tourists जो हैं, I think on first rank is Indians only, जो उनका sizable portion है tourism का.
Yes, the data says it clearly that Indian tourists are on top of the list of Maldivian tourism, and then comes Russia, and then comes China, whom they are shaking hands with. So if they, if Indians boycott Maldives, it is going to impact the Maldivian government and economy in a very bad manner, indeed. So let's go to the Bollywood side now. Many of the Bollywood celebs are coming up on social media and saying that we should be promoting domestic tourism, despite the fact that they themselves have gone there and chilled for their vacations. But now they are saying that we won't go. We have visited, but we won't go now, and you should be also not going. So celebrities like Salman Khan, Akshay Kumar, Sachin Tendulkar, Hardik Pandya, Kangana Ranaut, Shraddha Kapoor, many are coming on social media and saying that we should be promoting domestic tourism. It's the power of leadership, Ansh, because PM Modi visited Lakshadweep, and everyone started saying about that. So we will ask Ishika that on this, the Bollywood celebrities promoting domestic tourism, despite the fact that they have themselves gone there, what do you think on this whole thing?
Okay, I would like to give an advertising example.
Okay.
Few years back, when Domino's were there in the market, and suddenly Subway came with their sandwiches, then Domino's ka market went down. Then Domino's came up with sandwiches, and literally in their advertising, they put like Domino's ka sandwich and Subway ka sandwich, and the people were literally choosing Domino's ka sandwich. So Subway wale ne inko ek letter bheja ki you can't do this advertising mein. Domino's wale ne kya kiya, they put their pizza and that letter into the oven and say, why are you fearing this? If your sandwich is so great, matlab itna achha hai, then why are you like itna dar kyun rahe ho with that market? So I think on this comment should be like ki if Maldives tourism is so strong, so इतना derogative statements like against PM Modi देने का कोई ज़रूरत ही नहीं था. If they are so confident about their beaches, their food, their delicacies, then no need for such statements. And coming on the celebrity part, I think food which I have tasted, I might not taste again. Example. So I think अगर celebrities have already gone there, and if they are posting a boycott Maldives, I won't support that. If a normal Indian is doing that, I might be, because they have not gone there, and if they are supporting PM Modi for this, then I would go with Indian people.
I also think so, yeah, because you might not go now, but you have gone there. It's my personal point of view. So coming up on social media and giving lecture to the normal audience that you should be not going, and domestic tourism promotion, you have yourself chilled there. So I don't think that it correlates in this case. Veer Das, the comedian, Emmy Awards winner, he recently came up with a hilarious comment that those influencers and celebs who are recently in Maldives, they have done all of that picture thing and control sold their cards. Now they can't post on social media.
I think all the celebrities should delete all their Maldives pictures from their Instagram account.
Some are deleting.
They should.
So he's saying, what about those celebrities now? Now they can't even post those pictures which they have worked for so long. Anyways, this is what me, Ansh and Ishika think on this Lakshadweep versus Maldives trend which is buzzing all over in India. Tell us, what do you think on this topic and what's your next destination to visit? See you next time. Thank you so much for watching.